Thank you to everyone for being here today. Now I'm going to take you with me on an audition in Rome that I was very excited about. It did seem that my luck was changing, even though the economy was bad, and even Italian actors were having trouble finding work. Ricardo, the agent who worked out at my gym, thought I was a good type for pubblicità, TV commercials, and set me up for an ad for mozzarella cheese. I immediately made an appointment with a hairdresser so I would look as good and Italian as possible. I went through my closet and chose a black form-fitted skirt and pink blouse. On camera, those colors looked good on me. Often there was copy to read or try to memorize quickly, but I wouldn't know until I got there. At 10 the next morning, I was en route to the casting director's office, my head held high. Here I was in Rome on my way to my first audition. At the casting director's office, I sat in the last available seat. All the other actresses had short skirts. Mine was knee length and tight blouses. They had long, heavy hair that partly covered their face, while I always wore my long hair loosely tied back. Did they know something I didn't? Or was I the standout, the one who got attention for being different? There was no script. I wondered what I would be doing for this audition, aside from eating cheese. After 45 minutes of fidgeting and adjusting my hair and applying more lipstick, the casting director, unshaven and with a big toothy grin, called my name. "Buongiorno," I said inside the audition room. There was a single camera and a table with a big plate of cheese. It was a good thing I was not lactose intolerant. "Eat the cheese and look directly into the camera," he instructed me in Italian. "Look sensuous while you are saying buonissimo, buonissimo." "Very good." "Look sensuous?" I was way too nervous. During the first take, I spit cheese from my mouth while trying to say buonissimo. He told me to do it again. He used his hands theatrically to suggest the heights of ecstasy I should be feeling as I sampled the cheese. I tried again. As I put the second piece of cheese in my mouth, I puckered my lips and tried to look carnal. Buonissimo. It was just one word, but the cheese got stuck against my teeth. I did it again. This time, as I swallowed the cheese, I bit my tongue and felt a dab of blood inside my mouth. I did not feel sensuous, and I was pretty sure I didn't look it either. I did 5 more takes before it was over. I wouldn't know for a while whether I had landed the gig, and I had probably consumed a full day's allotment of calories from fat and dairy, but I felt proud of myself. I had the interest of agents, and I had gone on an audition, and I felt fantastico. And now I'm just going to read a snippet of a brief visit home. Spending a few weeks back home was good for me. I saw my friend Denise in New York, let my mother and George pamper me in Florida, and saw American doctors in both cities who brought me back to health. My mom and I spent quality time staying up late, talking and knitting. "I'm so proud of you, honey," she told me. "I could never do what you've done." I had always lived to please her, and it was a rush to feel that I had succeeded. When I returned to Rome in January 1996, my young Italian hairdresser was waiting at the airport to greet me. To find out more about that, you're going to have to read the book. He had called me at my mother's place on Christmas Day, a lovely surprise. We kissed at the arrival's gate like new lovers, eager to hold each other again. Somehow, he managed to get my huge black suitcases into his tiny, efficient Renault. While driving back to my apartment, he turned silent. "Dimmi tutto," I said. "Tell me everything." "I am afraid," he said. "I don't want to fall in love with you." "Oh, what's changed?" I asked, but he wouldn't answer. I was frustrated and nearing the end of my patience. What was it with these Italian men? What didn't I understand about them or about me? We arrived at my apartment. to find that there was no hot water. Too jet-lagged to care, I lay on the bed with Federico, and within a moment, there was a giant cracking sound. The mattress fell through the broken frame to the floor. Under other circumstances, I might have laughed, but not now. I am afraid you will not stay in Italy, Federico said. I don't want to get hurt. What do you mean? I really like it here, I said from a mattress on the floor of an apartment with no hot water.